Hello, hello.
Hello, welcome, guys.
Welcome to episode 9, Road to Graduation Edition of your favorite podcast about a Japanese idol group ranging from 5th year elementary to 3rd year middle school. I'm one of your hosts, Sour Patch Parents. Then we go down the line, introduce everybody else.
Hey.
Hi.
What's up?
Okay. Cool.
Oh. Okay.
Good job, guys.
Hi. I'm Continua. If you don't know me already, welcome to the show. Jesus Christ. Okay.
My name is Austin. I go by Fukei Middle on Reddit. Nice to meet you.
Hey, I'm Sutia. Nice to meet you. That's all. Start the show.
Smiling faces, everybody. Mwah. Start of a new Nendo. Happy Nendo 2017, everybody.
I mean, it's not really.
All right.
It's the reign of Aiko. Be prepared.
Not yet. I don't want to invent that yet.
You mean reign of greenness?
Just accept it into your heart. You guys need Aiko in your heart.
There's too many.
Everybody Aiko. Needs Aiko in their heart.
Too many. Okay. Anyways. RTG special. There's a couple of our hosts went to Japan, went to RTG, did some Sakura Gakuen things, and yeah. You guys want to talk about your experiences?
Heck yeah.
Starting with Fukei Middle, yes?
Yeah, I mean, this is, well, first, before the final, obviously, there was the pre-live, that was my first time seeing Sakura Gakuen. So obviously that was the trip, like one of the highlights of the trip, because it was my first time seeing them in person.
How did you feel when you see them first on stage? And just kind of like describe it, I guess, for anyone who hasn't seen SG Live yet.
Well, for someone who like was almost, I wanted to cry. I know one of my friends actually did cry, or he was tearing up when he saw them live for the first time.
I probably would have. So, yeah,
just amazing seeing them. I couldn't, really high number on the ticket thing, so I had to go in like pretty late. So there's some people, you know, tall people in front of me. If you don't know, I'm really short, but
yeah.
That was,
oh, yeah, it's all...
That kind of sucks, but I mean, I could still see them just fine, so it was still awesome. Yeah. I had another friend who was up front, and pretty close, and I'm sure he got plenty of attention because he was like probably the tallest person there.
that's funny. Nice.
He's right at the front. I feel sorry for the people behind him.
Yeah,
but that first experience was awesome. Seeing everybody, I think that was the first time I had ever been around so many Fukei.
Oh man, I'm sure a lot of us envy you so much. Yeah,
at an RTG event, yeah, more normally it's just Fukei amongst the baby metal fans. But yeah, really awesome.
All right,
dude. Performance
since
and everything.
Since everybody here went to Japan, what can you guys like describe Japan's like to someone who's never been? Since everybody here's been to Japan, konnichiwa and tutti. Don't want to give too much of a light to Austin now, but
you've never been to Japan. It depends on your image of Japan beforehand. If you think it's like, I don't want to use a bad term.
If you think it's like, if you think it's like into an anime, you're gonna be disappointed.
Yeah, if you think it's anime country, I mean, yeah. you can go to a place where it's basically anime, but for the most part, it's a very I don't know. What's the word? It's very normal.
busy. Not normal. It's a lot different. I mean, from where I am anyway, it's a lot different than.
It's a good mix up of big buildings and nature, in my opinion.
Yeah, there's a lot of like you'll be like amongst like a bunch of buildings, and you go around a corner, and there'd be like a really nice temple.
Yeah, it's more natural than you think, but it's also more industrial.
Yeah,
it's pretty advanced.
Endless buildings.
Endless, yeah.
It's advanced, but also like not advanced.
Yeah.
I'm using all these contradictory like statements, but it's
I know what you mean. I know what you mean. It's a beautiful balance of like modern and sticking to its culture at the same time.
Yeah.
Quinoa, you have anything? Oh, sorry.
Japan is 70% mountains, so only 30% of it, or 35% of it, is like city.
Yeah. So everybody wants to see
it. It's the same for Earth, though. Like 70% of the Earth is water. But no one cares about that.
I care about that.
Yeah, no one bothers. I feel like a lot of people go to Japan just because of anime or J-pop. And that's a good reason to go. But if you're there, you should go see like everything else.
It's actually really beautiful. Because I went to Yamanishi while I was there, and that's like I had seen nothing but buildings before I went to Yamanishi, and the mountains out there are like just amazing.
Yeah. You know what else is in Japan? little show called Torahime, featuring one of our graduates, Hana. Suti and Fukei medal were there. What was that like, guys, seeing the Taguchihana in person?
It was awesome.
For both me and Austin, it was the first time this time around. Right? Yeah, because you went before, because you went to Tokyo Dome.
Yeah, I went twice before, but this time, I think the first two times. I went multiple times, by the way. The first time, I don't think I went alone the first time. It was, who did I go with? I don't know. I just went with some friends. And arriving there, thankfully, the staff remembered me people a lot, so that was nice. I was always is also, you know.
Yeah.
But this time, different from last time, we actually got to talk to Hana.
Oh, snaps.
A handful of us met her. My friends, I think, was like the first of us to meet her.
Yeah.
And he like shook her hand and whatnot to her and like said, "Hey, I'm from Texas." And then he started like, because he cries really easily. He started to cry. And then like, I guess he walked away. Hana looked like, after that happened, like not too long after, before we were about to leave, Hana walked out of the kitchen. It looks like she was wiping tears. Like she might have even gotten emotional, just the fact that someone else got emotional.
Life would have been complete for me at that point. someone being happy to like that. I am a fan of crying. It's meeting me. That's.
To be fair, sweet feeling. Things make you feel things. Like, for example, if someone yawns, you're more likely to yawn if you see someone. So,
if you see someone cry, you're more likely.
You see somebody murder somebody, you'll probably murder somebody. So
it's true. It's right. It's actually true.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, yeah. So as we went to Torahime, we beat Hana, and actually one of my friends that I met during my first visit to Torahime was there. He met me there, and he was able to translate for me what I wanted to say to Hana, and like we were just talking back and forth.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my friends was just sitting in the distance, like jealous, because he didn't want to come over and like interrupt. I asked her like, or I told her where I'm from, and like told her like all of us were Fukei from America, and we.
Yeah.
Her and Sakugakuin, and asked her like if she was going to road to graduation, and she said she couldn't because she was going to be at Torahime working.
Mm-hmm.
So that's why you didn't see Hana in the final photo.
Yeah, insider scoop, Fukei Hangout exclusive.
No, really.
No one else.
inside scoop. when we were.
Yeah.
She finished like saying, you know, I'm talking to me, Hana, I'm like this year in high school and blah blah blah. She as she was running off the stage, she did like the Hana shrug. that iconic like shrug she does. She did that like just kind of as a what would I call it?
A tribute?
Yeah, kind of like a little tribute to the SG fans that were in the building.
Yeah,
she did that. And on stage.
There it is.
But yeah, that was really cool.
Yeah.
How was your experience, Frankie?
Things are different. Well, I don't know about you. I think you said you watched this, you watched the same show as from your first time.
I watched both shows the first time, but then the second time.
But was it a different show?
All the same shows.
No, he's talking about the setup. Like, you know, the Torahime changes
every 6 months. Same thing?
Yeah, it was the same.
Oh, okay. Because you guys didn't know Torahime, every few months, they'll change the theme of their show, and the whole entire show will be different. Because I went last year and around the same time in March, and then this year around the same time in March, and it was a completely different show. I thought it was better for the most part, but I think last year's a pretty interesting too, because they had this thing they did last year where they stopped moving in place to start the show. They were like serving drinks and stuff, and they stopped moving in place. And it kind of like got everyone confused. Yeah, kind of got everyone confused, and then they started the show from there, which I thought was pretty cool. So they had a bunch more different elements last year, but I felt overall the show was a bit better this year, because I especially like the Latin part, you know, where they had the colorful dresses and they did the kicks and stuff, and then Captain. I don't know. Captain is like she's like they have a group of people there, you know, in the cast, of course, and one of them is the captain, so I just call her Captain. And the captain was dressed up she dressed up as like one of those kind of stereotypical Latin men where there's a big hat and they have like a mustache and they're playing a guitar. She dressed up as one of those, and I thought that was really great, and she did a really good like scream, so I really like that part of the show.
Yeah, that girl, I know who you're talking about.
Yeah
mm-hmm. I wish we could take pictures. That's probably why you have maybe no pictures of Torahime, like the show that we're talking about. But,
I thought you could take pictures during the show.
Nope.
Couldn't you?
They don't. Well, okay.
There's a segment where you can take pictures.
But on the show that we saw, they don't allow pictures at all.
Oh, okay. The entire show. Okay. I don't want to be taking pictures while watching the show.
Pictures at the last song. But anyways.
Yeah, when I saw it, I was like, oh, picture showing? Take as many photos as I can while trying to do it at the same time, like watch it and stuff.
Yeah. Frankie talked about it, didn't he?
Wait, what?
Did you talk to
you
Hannah?
You talked to Hannah, didn't you?
No. If it was on that night, I had a friend with me, and he wanted to leave early. He had the key. He had the key, so I couldn't really stay up.
Not go with him.
Yeah, not go with him.
Yes.
So I had to leave early. So if it was that night, no, I didn't get to talk to Hannah, which is sad, but
yeah.
Can you do?
Yeah. Torahime is a great show. Like, even like without Hannah, still like a wonderful performance.
Yeah, definitely. But,
like,
it's
they give it their all. It's a must see when you're in Japan.
The staff is really nice too. Like, they're really chill.
I would say it
serves you and performs.
Yeah, worth the $40? Yeah. So, thirty if you're younger.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wait, was it 30 if you're younger? Or is it 40?
I think it's 40 if you're younger.
Oh, 40 if you're younger. 50 if you're not as young.
We're talking about American dollars because most of us here are American. So.
Oh yeah,
convert that as you will into your currency. Determine the price of that. But now. Appetizers over. We're on here to that filet mignon.
Mignon.
While you're all here, road to graduation special.
Yeah, our
more talking of. Yeah.
It surprisingly. Well, I don't know if it's surprising to many. Surprising for me. Every year before this, it happened on a Sunday, but it happened to be on a Saturday this time, So what happened was a lot of us went to Torahime on Friday, and then RTG was the next day. So it was a good follow-up.
Yeah.
I got there 8? Was it? Awesome. When did you get there? I think I got there like 30 minutes before you or something like that, or an hour before you.
Yeah, probably an hour because I was pretty far back in line. But I think I got there around 10.
10?
Maybe
9.
Probably around 9 actually. So you probably got there at 8.
Yeah, I probably got there at 8.
But I got there and the line was not as long as I expected.
Yeah, it definitely wasn't. But it was still. It was okay. The wait was okay. We had to wait until 2.
Yeah.
2, so it was a few hours. But it was fun because we got to see a bunch of other people. And there were actually guys. Passing out little postcards, message cards that you can write a message on, and they would collect them all and give it, put it in a bag and give it to the graduates. So they were passing that out when everybody was in line. People got in, they got a bunch more, and you can take one for Sara, you can take one for Mirena, and write your own message to them. So I thought that was really cool. Someone who was sitting next to me in line was an artist, or not an artist, I guess, but really liked drawing, and he was drawing Sara and Mirena the whole time, and I thought that was really good. I wanted to ask if I could take a picture, but it was kind of awkward, or I didn't want to be awkward, so I didn't do it.
Hey, if you're out there, no, I'm kidding.
I guess.
Yeah, just meeting, I got to talk to I met a lot of people.
Oh yeah, Austin the rich man
at Red to graduation. Freaking people I was talking to in line thought I was rich because I came from America.
That's what everybody thinks.
Oh, so you're rich because you came all the way from America for Red to graduation. It's like, no, I see my life, sir.
Yeah.
But yeah,
it was funny too because after we got our merch. Good.
No, I wasn't gonna say. Oh, anything.
I was just gonna say after we got our merch, we decided to go eat, and Austin saw the same people in the restaurant. People.
What are the odds? Same people. We walked all the way to that same exact restaurant. It was like some.
What did you write? I just wrote some really silly stuff. Oh, really hope you get. Really hope you do well after graduation. Wish the best of luck to you. The card wasn't that big, so you couldn't really write that much unless you wrote really small print. but I tried to write something in Japanese, so it would be somewhat understandable. So I didn't get to write much. It was more like, it was more just like a good luck in your path, and you do well kind of thing. Congratulations.
I didn't want to write anything too complicated because I know they will have to translate it because I was writing in English.
Onji was online. I think Austin and I have both met Onji before this. So, yeah.
But he was there. The pleasure of being in the presence of Onji, being in presence of Onji while RGG was happening, Frankie.
Oh, yeah, because I had trouble getting a ticket. So, kind of last minute, he offered his to me. Because he bought two, because in case Fukei needed help, which the Fukei was me. So I ended up sitting next to him throughout the hard RTG.
Shout out to Onji.
Shout out to Onji. He's the real guy.
Real OG.
The real MVP.
Now more about the performances now.
Oh yeah, let's go on to that.
Yeah, the set list was a little surprising, honestly. I was not expecting Sayonara.
I don't know if you have anything to say about Austin, but I thought it was really interesting. But the only thing I didn't really like about the set list was that they didn't really have many flag songs. They actually only had one flag song, which was Message, yeah. And then compared to last year, where they had like three or four flag songs, they only had one this year, which was kind of disappointing.
Why don't they have like Yumeni Mikate? That seems pretty
That's the first standard. Yumeni Mikate.
I think they should have had that.
I think they're trying to mix it up for us, like because maybe they were like, oh, we had it on the album again. You know, who knows what goes through their minds? They're really confusing choices, but for some reason didn't have Yumeni Mikate.
Yeah,
I thought it was funny about it.
I'm glad they had Heart no Hoshi though, because. Yeah. That's like my favorite song.
Actually, I really do like Heart no Hoshi, but I thought that was the worst song.
Wait, really?
Because to me, live, it sounded the worst to me. To me, it sounded the worst.
That's fair.
Because it had the most autoplay.
Well, I think Heart no Hoshi, that has like, out of the set list, that probably has one of the hardest choreographies.
Yeah,
a little bit.
They're not going to focus on their singing for that song for sure.
Fair point.
Yeah, it was really enjoyable. What seat did you have, Frankie?
I had a pretty bad seat. I was second row. I was like fourth row of the second floor, which is not bad considering that there are rows in the first floor that are behind my seat, so technically I had a better seat than them, but it still wasn't like nowhere even close to. Because last year I had a way better seat. It was I don't know if you guys saw pictures of them last year running in, or if you watched the RTG, you knew that they would run. They for the start of Misasa Super Lady, they ran in from the side entrances, and I was kind of like in front of them when they were running, so I got to see them last year. So this year was definitely interesting for me.
They had giant balloons that they threw out to the crowd.
That was really good. Instead of the shirt cannon, they had giant balloons.
The upgrade.
It was cool.
Sort of, not really.
One of them actually ended up on stage for a little bit.
Oh yeah, someone bounced it back to stage.
Yeah.
But anyways, let's see. I was in row 10, and for some reason there was a guy, and that's really close, but there's a guy in row 7 that was using binoculars.
Oh yeah, Onji had binoculars too.
Okay, but he was like way back there, isn't he?
Yeah, okay, but Onji needed the binoculars, but that
yeah, guy in row 7 didn't need binoculars. But yeah, so that was a really good seat to have.
Yeah. Now, Frankie, you went to RTG last year and this year, so 3 straight years. How would you compare the experiences? Like, was last year better? Was this year better?
Like, experience-wise, last year was better because, you know, better see the girls in front of me and stuff. You know, just better seat in general usually tends to make a better experience. But in terms of the actual RTG, I thought this year's was better. I liked the different set lists. I felt like there were more emotions compared to last year. Overall, I felt RTG was better, but in terms of my experience, last year was better.
Yeah. I was surprised Sarah. Not really, though. Sarah didn't cry very much. Maybe, like, teared up, but really didn't cry. But I was crying, like, by the time Mikansei Silhouette came on, I was crying, because...
I think I'd be gone by then. I would definitely be gone by that spot.
Mikansei Silhouette, like, really is what took me. It was done.
I can't even listen to Mikansei, like... Get
him live. It's a really good song.
Yeah, it's
Now, I'm pretty sure people are wondering about this, but who do you guys think cried the most and cried the least
in your
experiences? Oof. The most? So you cried the most? From your guys, what you can see.
Tsugumi cried a lot.
Tsugumi.
Wow, looking forward to that Blu-ray. Sugu tears.
HD Sugu tears.
HD Sugu tears. Yes.
The person who cried the least. I remember. I said Sarah. Two people didn't cry. Like, it almost didn't cry at all. I think it was Momoko and Soyo. I forgot exactly who was two, but I remember Momoko for sure. Mm-hmm. And the second one, I think, was Soyo.
Mm-hmm.
Think
I had the most. Megu definitely.
Megu?
Megu.
From all the pictures, she looked really devastated. So but that's just.
Well, she did look the most.
Megu joined with Sarah, so I think I would understand that one.
She was devastated.
She definitely looked the most devastated, but did she cry the most?
Like, yeah, she was crying nonstop. Crazy.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Okay, you know,
yeah, not everybody needs to be a crybaby in SG. It's nice to have some of them.
No. I disagree. There are too many dry years.
Voltix said mine cried the least, but I didn't see Sarah really cry at all.
Was it Momoko? Oh, no. You're right. It was Momoko and Marty. There you go. It wasn't Sarah. It was Momoko and Marty. There you go.
Separate tears on logo. Drive on metal said mine. You separate tears on logo.
Yeah, I just like the balance between tears and no tears. So
yeah,
I felt we had too many drag. I miss the tears.
I just feel like it's a generation thing. Like I feel like 2016 was a start of I feel like the tears is the example of a new generation of SG like truly starting. Because it's opposed to the last few years where there hasn't been much, but that's just like, my two cents.
I feel like the transference always cry a lot every year.
Yeah.
Sometimes, yeah. See that?
I mean, I expected more crying last year from six transfer.
I can't remember Yuzumi's face.
I saw a few pics of Yuzumi being like destroyed. Yeah.
There were some graduates there.
Did you guys run into me? Graduate sighting?
No, I didn't. But my friend, who was on the first floor, thought he saw Ayami. Okay. One. But Ayami was in the graduate pictures, but maybe she's not allowed to be, so who knows? And then he definitely saw Yui. He saw Yui there on the first floor. I wish I had walked back. If there wasn't an intermission, I actually like walked out thinking there would be an intermission at some point. The actual, like, diploma thing.
Mm-hmm.
The lights kind of came on and a bunch of people started walking out. So I'm like, oh, I guess there's an intermission. But I like, went to a vending machine, got a drink. And then I started hearing Mori Sensei talking. So I was like, oh, crap. I just chugged my drink. Actually, I brought my drink in with me. Watch.
The rule break.
Yeah.
Yeah, I broke the rules. Please don't report me.
Oh, no.
For me, I kind of knew because I remember last year someone told me that they came in through the front. You know, they don't go in through the back. And that you wait long enough that you could actually see them coming in. So I kind of like cheekily waited on the second floor because my seat was in second. Watched the entrance for a little bit.
But and then come on the second floor.
No, I know, but you can see the entrance. You can see the entrance. So you could have seen them walking in. And I didn't. I was like thinking the whole time, should I take the gamble? Because either I see the girls and I miss some part of the show, or I miss a really big part of this, like a really surprising part of the show, like they do something like good, or like I just missed Bisasa Super Lady in general.
Dude, yeah, like
for a while.
Pretty worth gamble, he asked me.
When the lights like turned off, like I was not outside the venue, but like outside the doors, on the second floor as well. And I was just like hoping. But there, no, nobody came. I think they show up like 5 minutes after the show starts. So they don't miss too much.
Yeah. I think next year, if I can make it, I think I would take the gamble because nothing really that big happened. Like I was just thinking, like maybe they do something like really crazy, like maybe like make something go through the air or something.
yeah. That's kind of what I was afraid of missing.
Acrobatics, SG. Like all the members are like flipping and
yeah, not that far, but like yeah, like maybe I missed something like oh no, I missed it live, and I couldn't, and somehow I didn't end up seeing the girls walk to the entrance anyway, so I would have just missed both. Like you know, like it's that possible way that goes through your head. I'm just like, I guess I'll just go away.
I was kind of worried. Like I thought they were gonna I figured okay, they're probably not gonna run through the aisles because there's a bunch of stairs that they got to run down, even though that's not hard, but like the stairs and the photographers in the aisles. So
yeah,
closing the doors when I was outside. So I was like, oh crap, I better go in. Cause like, what if they close the doors when the show starts and I can't go in after it starts? That would suck.
Oh yeah. Like I kind of knew that they would open the doors for me, but I kind of like, what they don't though? What they just like kick me? Like you know, there's like
you're not sure. There's that small
1% that like in your head, you're like, oh, that 1% happens.
Yeah,
it's like you end up like losing the bet against yourself.
Yeah, I feel like trying to see a graduate is always worth the gamble for something like that. But
I'm pretty sure there's some people that didn't go to road to graduation that was like standing outside the venue. Just mm-hmm. waiting.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Yeah, sure. Definitely.
Baby metal fans.
Yeah, yeah. And metal, Austin. Hana wasn't the only graduate. You were in the presence of. There was one other, super famous girl now, super lady now. You want to talk about that?
Miyoshi Ayaka. I was able to meet her. So like left my friend's like, hey, there's this lottery that we can maybe meet Ayaka. So we just did it to one of our friend's house in Japan, and I was on the train one day, I looked at my phone and hey, congratulations, you won the lottery, and a couple of my friends won as well. So
you won the lottery, Emily.
Yeah, we got to we were able to meet Ayaka, so we went to Shibuya at this big building that's and so we go in. The security was actually pretty tight for Ayaka. There was like a couple police that was like blocking your view, so you couldn't see her until it was actually your turn. to meet her, but you could hear her talking, like, if you were in, because it was like kind of in a library, looking place.
Library.
Yeah. It was really quiet. Talking.
You're a.
Yeah. So. All my friends. Say again. What were we gonna say?
No. I was just gonna say that you had a tiny little conversation with her, and what was that like? What'd you guys say? Would you guys exchange?
Oh, words and stuff? Okay. So that day, my voice was voice, and didn't really say anything. So
extremely unlucky.
Yeah, that was really unlucky, but it like gained me some sympathy for my Yaka. So it was my turn, and I had like what I wanted to say typed out on my phone, but of course, you know, with security, they might not allow that because some show some picture that they shouldn't show. So I asked the security, like, completely gone voice, if I could show her what I wanted to say. And on my phone, I said, like, hi, I'm from America. My name is Austin. I lost my voice at the road to graduation. I'm sorry. So sorry I can't talk. But yeah, she was like, oh, is your voice? She said, oh, are you okay? In English, by the way. She spoke a little bit of English.
Yes.
Yeah, so she asked me if I was okay in English. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I'm okay. And typed down on my phone. I was okay, and I said yeah in Japanese, and she was like, oh, you speak Japanese? And I'm like, I'm studying Japanese. And she said, wow, it's really good, like every Japanese person does when you say the smallest bit of Japanese.
Yeah, definitely.
And yeah, it was short. It was like a minute, if you think about it, a minute with Ayaka.
60 seconds.
Yeah. So that it was really good. And they gave me a signed photo. Or she handed me a signed photo as I walked out.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Signed Ayaka photos. And my friend, graduation, she nodded her head, but I don't think she actually understood what he said. So she just nodded her head.
Oh. Like, yeah. Yeah. So understand something? Just nod your head. Nod your head. Yep. Definitely. Yeah, sure. Yeah. And with...
Oh, I'm sorry. I know we kind of moved on a bit. I kind of just want to go back a little bit and say that... after graduation, because this thing happens where, you know, the streamers explode, or like they have an explosion during one of the lost lungs, and a bunch of confetti or like streamers fly out, and that's actually a thing for KD. After the RTG, they gather the little ribbons as like a piece of memorial, because they actually say, like, Sakura Gakuen wrote to the graduation the year, and then I think they say the graduates as well. And then so as me and Onji was going down to the first floor to collect those ribbons, because some I actually saw the Hot Wave interview. That was pretty cool, and Onji helped me say some stuff to him.
Oh, you talked to him?
Yeah.
The guy from Hot Wave.
And also after that, we had a Fukei dinner afterwards. And like Austin said, he lost his voice. A Fukei dinner? like a dinner afterward?
Oh, yeah.
You guys ate Fukei? What?
Yeah, we ate other Fukei. Yeah, but it was funny trying to understand Austin, because he lost his voice immediately after RTG. It wasn't just like the next day, and he had to type out a lot of the stuff.
Yeah, I completely, like, I think one of my friends thought I cried so much that I couldn't talk, but that wasn't the case. I just lost my voice, because a lot of us ended up getting sick while we were in Japan, but... I think part of getting a cold, eventually my voice got lost, and it took like forever to come back.
Yeah, I'm actually surprised, because I feel like years are used to colder weather than, at least where I'm from, at least California.
Oh.
I've lived in different parts of the country, so.
Sick, though. It's like, I haven't been sick in years until then. But yeah. Picked up some streamers too. I have three in my closet right now.
Sell them for lots of money. Or give them special Fugue gifts, whatever you want.
Yeah, I'll send some to some friends.
All right. And with graduation is the departure of two members. Kuroshimasera, Kurosawa Mirena. I butchered those probably really bad, but this part we're just gonna talk about them and their impact on SG. But first, we have a little video organized by our tech team member Doug, aka the Goomer Twin. So it's a little video before we talk about our recent graduates.
Somewhere, somehow, I know that I'm
So that was a pretty good
good OG my, song and edit by our tech team.
Let me put my onions away real quick.
Bye-bye.
Okay. Sorry for not giving the feels warning ahead of time.
Yeah. A good cry is needed every now and then. Good cry. Now, each of us is just going to say a few words, or a lot of words, whatever you prefer, on our two recent graduates. Who wants to start?
I'll start. Okay.
All right. Yeah, suits you, so you start.
Okay. So, let
Austin rest his voice since he's been talking a lot recently. So, give him a minute to rest. All right. But yeah, Suti, please.
For Sarah, there's two sides when it comes to her in 20. You either really liked her in 2014, or you didn't notice her in 20. That's my opinion. But as time progressed, she became very apparent, very good leader. And despite a post I made, whether you know that post or not, I'm glad Sarah became president. It worked out for the best. I hope she has a good career, which although I'm surprised that she chose acting instead of modeling. But I hope she succeeds.
Why not both?
Yeah, why not both? But I'm sorry. So I really hope she's a person. As for Mirena, 2 years. Came in, big pop. She was brought in to help. She left so much more impact than just helping Sarah became who she is. She instantly became a lot of our favorites. At least mine, at least. Became mine, at least. And I'm not going to go into more, but I hope the best for both of them. I'm glad that it turned out this way.
All right. Year grew on me a lot, so much so that she's like my second favorite, second to Megu. So seeing her go is not easy for me, but I'm really glad entertainment industry and chose acting, which I'm also kind of surprised. I thought she'd choose modeling. You can do both, probably. It kind of goes hand in hand in some situations. Is like one of my favorite members. I love her personality and everything. And as for Mirena, I think it's going to grow on me. Even though she's gone, but going back and watching videos, I feel like she's just going to grow on me more and more, and then I'm going to end up missing her more and more. Sarah and the rest of the... Yeah, I'm going to miss them both.
Indeed. Prepared some notes. Talk about these two recent graduates. Actually, throwaway. I can say what I feel, if you feel me.
stupid puns, star pageant. All right.
Sarah in SG was, I feel like she was a safe option for president. That can't be a bad thing. Like, not all presidents can be like amazing, but I feel like she did what she could have, Miss Nendo. I feel like I agree with Frankie in saying, I feel like she has a big modeling career ahead of her. And it did surprise me as well that she chose, she's going to choose acting, but hopefully we'll get some modeling gigs for her too.
Yes.
Yeah. Sara wasn't really someone, honestly, who didn't like really catch my eye until she was president. But when she did, she had sort of a nice composure, president, like more so than the past few that other presidents didn't really have. And finally, Mirena. Oh man, Mirena. This girl, I tell you, she has a knack for just being like really alive in herself in front of a camera. She's born to be in front of a camera, honestly. I wouldn't be surprised if like she came out of her mother's womb like, ah, la 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 la, you know? she's kind of born to do that, you know? And Mirena, I feel like for a lot of people, stood out. Nendo. She was just her facial expression, just everything about her was great, you know? Also an actress, maybe modeling gigs, who knows? Yeah, and I'll greatly miss them both because they're, I think right now, the beautiful thing about this is they didn't pull last year and go 100% stay in the entertainment industry for 2016 Nendo, at least for now. So miss them greatly. Thank you, Sara and Mirena, for your contributions to Sakura Gakuen. All right. And
is it my turn?
It is your turn, yes.
Okay. First thing I will admit is Sara and Mirena, this year, probably last year, they weren't that high on my list of favorites. But that being said, that doesn't mean they didn't have like that impact. Sara, I always thought she was like that quiet person. And then you see more of her, and you see that she's not as quiet as you thought.
Yeah, and she's just stage shy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't know, I was really impressed with her during the 2016 window. And Mirena, man, whoa.
Yeah.
Every time in Logo, I'd be so scared to, like, translate Mirena because of how much she talks, how much she says, and you know, I think that's really good quality though, and I think those two really, they brought out the best of 2016 though, and I wish them all the best.
Bye, both of them.
Yes.
Said. Now on to
I know we just kind of moved on past Sara and Mirena, but we're going to go back a little into one of them, Mirena at least, because she actually has some postgraduate work. Technically, it's not postgraduate, but it's postgraduate. She sang the Pon Pon Jump theme song for like that Sanrio kind of show. Song itself was good. I can't say much more about the actual song, but I do hope that this gives her more opportunities. So maybe she'll be like the face of Sanrio. Probably not, but maybe face of Sanrio.
Fingers crossed.
Local Sanrio shops.
Yeah.
Dude, I have a theory. I think Mirena is going to host the 2020 Olympics.
Okay.
2020 Olympics.
Whoa, slow down there. That's bold. That's bold, Cotton. Let's see if it pays off. That is bold. All right. Moving on. They had a little, Sara Mirena had a little signing event message. I don't know. I know there's at least one Fukei, international Fukei, that went. have any more info on that, Austin?
There was one international speaker who was able to, well, that we know of, that was able to go. I would have gone if I didn't leave on the 31st. And it really sucks because they didn't announce it until after I had booked my flights and stuff. So I couldn't really change my dates. And that was, like, really saddening, the fact that I wouldn't be able to go meet Sara or Mirena.
They probably did that on purpose to avoid international UK.
Yeah,
probably screw us over. But there was an international figure from Italy? Question mark. Yeah, Italy. To meet Sara, that's the person he chose. Because at this event, you actually have to choose one person you want to meet, so you don't get to meet both of them.
Extremely painful.
That's painful for, like...
Yeah, that's... Like, how do you make someone choose between Sara and Mirena? And he gave Sara a flag with Sakugakuen logo on it. And I thought that was really cool. And was that Sara basically mentioned him in the video. And in the video that they posted, I can't, on like Shelson's channel or something. It was a... Or in Fukei that came to see us, and she was really surprised and happy about that. Sara remembered him.
Yeah, it was Nightwisher. Nightwisher, the lucky bum.
Oh, well, what?
Nightwisher 77.
Wait, was it Nightwisher?
Yes.
I thought it was someone else.
According to chat, it was Nightwisher. So,
you mean according to
his? I only know his. You know, real name.
Oh, well, if you can, I can confirm for you.
We do want to reveal his name because we don't know.
No, no.
We know his real name. Don't worry.
I don't know his real name, so I don't need to know. All right, moving on.
But yeah,
a little bit of
excuse my lucky.
Yeah, extremely lucky guy. Moving on. Overture photos. I know this is kind of an old news, but I just want to harp on it. I just hope they do more photos like this, like the Overture photos. I couldn't recognize Sara when I first saw it, to be honest. But I really hope they do like more photo shoots like this with like the younger members like that.
Yeah.
Photos,
like, I was really surprised that they did a photo shoot like this. I was not expecting, like, I didn't know what to like expect when I got this book. And I was really happy with it. I just wish there were more pages of these kind of photos because these are really cool.
Yeah, definitely. All right. Enough.
Did you pick up this magazine? Okay, go ahead.
I did not. Wait.
I was talking to Frankie.
I picked up the one. The Overture one, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I got it.
Okay.
Really nice photos. I hope they do more in the future. But enough about the past. Talk about the not past, not present. That is also called the future. Frankie, you want to talk about the future?
The future and the topic of actually... Oh, never mind. The future, Amuse Festival, kind of, in a sense, SG's biggest stage so far.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, biggest stage so far. It includes almost all of Amuse acts. Missing two pretty big ones.
They're too big for festivals now, though. For Amuse-based festivals, at least. So
yeah, it's still pretty big. we'll have to see SG's actual length in the festival. See if it like expands your popularity. If you kind of know about Amuse, there's a good chance. I feel like that you would maybe know about SG, but maybe seeing them perform at the same stage as other Amuse acts will maybe pique your interest more. So mm-hmm. it could be a really good thing for them. And because they got a chance on this big stage, which they usually don't get chances on bigger stages, maybe this is a sign for them to get bigger gigs in the future. So mm-hmm. maybe it'll probably be good for them.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Was that bigger group that you said was too big? Was that what groups? What two groups?
I know one of them. And 1 o'clock.
One okay rock.
Baby Metal played there. They would just be nothing but Baby Metal fans, probably.
Yeah, I think so too.
And that would suck for like people who aren't Baby Metal fans that want to go, but then there's no ticket.
Yeah. I can see the complications of that. Just because
you can kind of say the same thing about Perfume.
Yeah, but
pretty big.
Yeah, Baby Metal's like the only Japanese artist that played like all of those venues and sell them out in Japan. So, as far as I know, at least, and then maybe 1 OK Rock too. I'm not too big of a fan of them.
One OK Rock.
That's a weak piece. It is. So I'm like,
keep living. One OK Rock. It's 1 o'clock.
You're saying 1 o'clock in a racist way. Because that's how Japanese. They don't say like. Oh, okay. Never mind. Okay.
All right.
PSA. This has been a PSA. It's 1 o'clock.
Okay.
Okay. Moving on.
Now, transfer ceremony is scheduled to happen May 7th. And I was just wondering everyone's thoughts and like, oh, hey, who do you guys expect to be transferring? What years, et cetera, et cetera. Everybody, I've been hearing a lot of talks about Karen from Chouse Miles transferring in.
Oh,
what do you guys think?
Transfer-ins, that's going to be the topic of our next show. So stay tuned for that. But I think
it's gonna be standard.
I think it's gonna be standard. Two transfer-ins. Most likely one girl from Chouse Miles. And I'm rooting for Lillian. If you don't know who Lillian is, the Chouse Miles streams. It's one of the newer members of Chouse Miles. And the other girl will probably be I think they're sixth graders next year, I think. I forget, but I think they're sixth graders next year. Or they'll come in into SGS sixth graders, so I mm-hmm. think the other transfer will be a fifth grader. And I don't mm-hmm. know who she'll be.
Yeah.
Hmm.
I'm gonna... Go ahead.
I was gonna say, I was kind of like... Even though I would like some of the, like... Chouse Miles members to come in to SG, I think it'd be kind of cool also just to have like completely new faces join.
Yeah, I would like that too. I mean, at this point, Chouse Miles is pretty much a development group for SG in a way. they pulled a lot of the members from Chouse Miles and SG.
Yeah.
So, yeah. And personally, my guess, I think it will be a fifth grader and sixth grader. I don't know who, but my guess is a fifth grader and a sixth grader.
My guess is gonna be fifth graders.
Two fifth graders?
Really? Do you think we're gonna have the Sarah situation again?
Boy, I did the math wrong. Sorry.
What?
Fifth grader
and a sixth grader. I'm going with game.
Well, since we kind of talked about this, what do you guys feel about getting two fifth graders? Well, like, because getting two fifth graders would kind of ensue. Well, it might ensue the Sarah thing again, because if we get two fifth graders, three people graduate the next year, and then you have three choices. You would end up having no first graders, two sixth graders, and no fifth graders. Would you invest two of your slots?
If they do transfer in fifth graders this year. That just leaves next year you can transfer into first grader.
Mm-hmm. Or two, three.
If anything, yeah.
Yeah, it would continue the thing of a first grader being transferred in, because assuming that they don't transfer in any first graders this year, this will be the first year they don't transfer in a first grader. But they've always transferred in a first grader.
Well, we're definitely not going to transfer first grade this year.
Oh, yeah, because... We're not going to get five 2019 grads.
But
who knows? If, Amuse. So
I'm just saying, if we go with the fifth grade, the two fifth grader route, it's going to be really awkward for Amuse because they'll have to transfer in three first graders, or else it'll be really awkward. Because if they transfer only one, they have the Sarah situation again, which is awkward. If they only transfer in two, they'll either have just double graduates again, which is kind of awkward, or they have to transfer in a third graduate later, which is, again, awkward because of the Mirena situation. So either way, it's really awkward.
You're awkward, Frankie.
I know. Ooh. I am. But it's not exactly a bad thing. It's not a good thing either.
Yeah, I think it's going to be one fifth grader and one sixth grader.
Yeah, I think that would be the... For the most part, everyone's safe bets. But yeah, that's...
Yeah.
Remember, how far in advance did they post that that video on YouTube of the rehearsal? Or the, what is it?
I think last year was like a day or two before.
Okay.
It's like right before.
Alrighty, cool. That sounds good.
Yeah.
I was wondering.
Yeah. We'll see come May 7th. So,
yeah.
And more talk about Ayaka. She's going to be cast in a movie. Inu Yashiki. She's not going to be a lead role, but going to be the lead role person's daughter. So, yay. More extra roles for Ayaka.
If some of you guys go through Manga websites, you might recognize the picture. It's like a picture. It's usually like a green background, and it's like an old man laughing. I haven't read it myself, but if you've been through like manga rankings and you see a picture of a green background and an old guy laughing, that's a new Yashiki.
Kyle asks us the roast section back again. No, it's not. It's not.
We'll let you know when the roast section is back. Unless you want us to roast. I mean,
let's see.
We have an audience to... fly with entertainment.
I'll save it for next time.
Pasty Upgoon McJones said he highly doubts any South Smiles girls will transfer in. Okay.
Thanks for your opinion.
Let's see.
Thanks for your opinion. Bye.
Also, he also says that it's Lillian.
Yeah, I read that. I didn't want to say anything. Yeah. Okay, Lillian. Not Lillian. Lillian. Oh.
So see.
Yeah. Yay.
Yuck, Magyar. I don't know how to say this guy's name. Magyar. He hopes that they don't transfer in any more girls who will only have 2 years in SG. How do you guys feel about this?
I'm glad Mirena transferred in. Honestly, if it was like maybe any other member, it probably would have not been worth it. But since it was Mirena,
it's something that usually wouldn't work out. Like Gabe's, just the fact that it was Mirena, it worked out.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. Yep. All right. And moving on to
Patsy. Moving on.
Whoever that is.
Pasty.
Anyways, Dave Metal News. Wow, it's been a while since they sold out their venue, Palladium. I'm gonna be at that show.
Oh yeah. Wait, they sold out. What did they sell out?
Palladium, their only solo show, or their only headlining show.
Yeah, their only headline show. They sold out, thankfully.
Yay.
I mean, I would expect them to. If they didn't, I'd be really sad.
Yeah, me too. Me too.
It was
really...
Is that show the fucking one in LA?
Yes, it is.
How dare you?
Yes.
How dare what?
How dare they go to LA again?
If you're LA, going to the Big Metal show in the chat,
LA is pretty cool, man.
People in the chat, if you're going to the Big Metal show, let us know. Just tell us. Just say I'm going.
Yeah, say I'm going.
Recent support events. Outfits. new baby metal outfits. I'm sure you've seen them.
They didn't change too much.
Mostly black.
Yeah, mostly black.
I personally red, but not a thing that Koba wanted. But, you know, who knows what Koba wants. yeah, so apparently I'm hearing that their skirts got shorter. I don't know how accurate that is, because I haven't actually had a close look.
Oh, wow. Yeah, me neither. I don't think there's been, like, a full photo yet of them. So
I've just seen some pretty good photos, but, yeah. Mostly black. I want more red. It's kind of like silver on the skirts.
They should, like, differentiate. Yeah. They should, like, differentiate the colors and make them, like, Power Rangers or something. That'd be cool. They're not going to do it.
That'd be crazy.
Amuse, you won't do that, but it'd be cool to see them, like, it'd be like Power Rangers performing and, like, dancing to metal music. That would increase the quality of big metal shows. If you guys feel me, you know what I mean?
Yeah, maybe.
And more baby metal news. The One concerts were announced. So,
oh yeah.
All those festivals
for fans too.
Yeah. Is this the first time they've done that? Or
for the, like, One concerts in Japan, this is the first time they have international, like,
yeah,
ticket opportunity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. I have some friends that are going, because they're also going to what's it called? Tokyo Idol Festival. They're going around that time. Yeah, they'll be going to that. And another thing, last thing, I think, for baby metal, is that they have a new call and response.
For Awadama FIBA.
Yeah, come in and see, or I don't, was it during Awadama Fever or was it during Karate?
I'm pretty sure Karate stayed the same, but Awadama Fever, that's what I heard from people.
Shizuka has everybody hold up their phones with their lights on.
Mm-hmm.
Looks amazing.
Yeah, that was nice.
And her English is really good as well. It's, you know, obviously it's
constantly as always. Yeah.
Yeah. The only thing the crowd
She's almost getting to Marin levels of English. Just kidding. That was a joke. I was joking. Yeah.
Frankie and Austin. This is from a question from Voltix. We're basically at the question. Wait.
You gotta ease into the. All right, now for our next segment, Frankie. You want to?
We're gonna do a QA section. Or segment, Japan/RTG special. So you have any questions about Japan,
or just anything,
or just in general,
like Star Pets parent, why are you such a fake Fukei or something like that? I don't know.
Yeah, something like that. You can ask about something like cultural, RTG, like. You think about a specific part that we didn't go over in our talk, something juicy that, what'd you guys do between Fukei, DA Spoon, or something like that? I don't know. You can ask some random questions. We have about two right here. Voltix asked, why didn't we hug? Did we not hug? I don't know. If we didn't hug, I just forgot. We just forgot to think about it. I hugged Fettuccine. If you guys know, who Fettuccine is, we finally met. We hugged.
Aww.
Get a room.
How did you feel? Me and Continua met in some random McDonald's in Shibuya.
Yeah.
I was literally like looking for her, like as we were texting. We were on Snapchat, and she was like snapping pictures of where we were, and she kept moving. Nice. So I was like following her. I swear, like she like just left a Adidas store, and I just left. But
it's hard because I was with my family, and they just want to go so many different places because it's their first time there. So I'm like, all right, now we're going to this place. And finally, in front of like McDonald's or something.
Randomly.
But do they put you on a leash and make you translate a whole bunch of stuff? Or is that just, never mind. Don't answer that. Moving on.
Voltix Frankie Austin, how did you feel when you waving your flags together with Japanese Fukei during message? It was one of my favorite moments. Austin, you want to say something first?
Sure. Yeah, it was awesome because it was my first time doing that. I had never seen so many SG flags in one place.
Mm-hmm.
Or at least with that many people. And it was like pretty, imagine. How was it for you, Frankie?
It was okay. Like I thought the flag segment this year was kind of short. Like I said, last year there were more. This year there's only like one. And in terms of doing something with Fukei, I also thought last year was kind of better because we got to do the Renown and Oga catchphrase with the crowd, which I thought was really amazing. Like when I was there, I was like, holy shit, we're actually doing it. So I thought that was really good. So in terms of experience, I felt like last year, flag experience, but it was nice.
Yeah. All right. Showtep is asking, just tuned in, but how do you feel about the increasing number of foreign fans going to RTG, Road to Graduation?
I think it's bad and good, in my opinion.
Why is it bad?
Well, okay. It's bad because it decreases chances. And the more foreign fans that become fans, this increases the fan base in total. And like I said, it not only makes tickets harder to get, but they also end up raising prices on tickets. So you're looking to buy in the aftermarket. Those tickets were
like
bloated. The prices are bloated.
It was insane.
Yeah, like last year, I bought a ticket, a really good ticket for like 100. I forgot the exact price. Like 100, like mid 100s, 150. A normal bad ticket this year was like 200, and if you wanted the good tickets were like 300. It's only if you got lucky that you got a really good price. So I think there are benefits and bad parts to there being more food in case.
Yeah.
Okay, Patsy. Patsy of Coon McJones.
Wait, Austin. Finish answering the Showtep's question first. We'll go down the line.
What was his question?
No. How do we feel about the number of foreign fans going to graduation?
Oh.
Frankie says it's good. Bad,
I think I like meeting people from around the world, not just Japan, but just all sorts of Fukei.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, that's really, it's just good. Mm-hmm. Only good.
I'm also kind of maybe in the same boat with Frankie, just because she's not really supposed to be something that's supposed to be super popular. So that whole idea of, oh, because there's more fans, they're going to have bigger venues, might not always be the case. So it's just like, maybe if like Amuse notices that there's a lot of foreign fans, they might increase the venue size or make more international stuff.
I don't think we really had much of a presence there. Like there was like maybe... Like, how many fans do you think there were? Like, foreign fans do you think were there, Frankie?
There is a good amount. Compared to last year, there's definitely way, way more. If you were there at both RTGs, you could tell the difference between the amount of foreign Fukei. I wouldn't say we, we're, like you said, a big amount, but compared to last year, it was definitely way bigger.
Okay, Frankie. This question is from
Patsy
of Okay.
Thank you, Patsy of Jones, for your question. Appreciate you.
How do you live with yourself?
How do you live with yourself, Patsy? That's a real question.
Not this episode.
Okay, TZ.
Turn off the camera.
I'm studying Japanese, planning on taking N4 exam next year. Is that enough to talk there? Or N3 is good enough? That's a real question for Continua, but I feel, even though I'm I don't have, I probably have way less Japanese experience class and level. I feel like it's more confidence and being able to speak it well, like getting a good accent and knowing how, what their not gestures, but their routines are. Like when they speak, they do things, they say things a certain way and say certain words. And nice. I think it's more, you just have to know how they speak, and the more words you know, it's of course it's better, but I think it's more important that you learn how they speak and, you know, their, like their routine. I can't find the exact word, but like their routines of sorts.
Their speech patterns, is that kind of what you're going
to? Speech patterns, there you go. Speech patterns.
Yeah, I think it's like just being a lot of it. Because like you might know like, you know, a handful of Japanese words and you might know how to use them, but when it comes to actually using them, confidence, and you're not comfortable, then it'll be a lot harder.
So
if you're just confident and comfortable, you'll get a lot further.
Okay. Yeah. This is actually a really embarrassing story I have. Okay, so when it comes to like talking like small talk in Japanese, I'm not like, you know, the most confident, but I can do like little words here and there, and I can do like very small talk with Japanese people. I thought I was doing pretty well on my trip until I got to Torahime, and my Austin knows the story too, and my friend had something he wanted to try to ask Hana if she could sign one of his things, which is a 2013 like bracelet thing. You guys know what that merch is. And I was like, you know, I'll do it for you. And I don't know, just maybe because I was talking to Hana, I got really nervous, and I just made like the simplest grammatical error ever, and it was really embarrassing. And like, what? It just didn't come out right, and I felt really embarrassed the whole night. But and yeah, it was really bad, really, really bad.
On the plus side, she did understand what you were trying to get at. Like, even if you don't know everything, but she understood what you're trying to say, and she said in response, only the pamphlet and t-shirt can get signed. Like, you can't sign SG merch.
All right.
So, yeah. If you're, wait, hold on. See if there's any. We got more questions.
No, there's more questions. Voltix asks, what was your favorite choreography? New mini Pata song was great, but Yubi Kiri was awesome. At Frankie and Austin.
At just us?
Just you.
Yeah, I like Yubi Kiri too. what else? Can you think of any, Austin?
My favorite is probably. Man, it's hard to decide.
I think he's talking from the show specifically. Like, what are your items?
I think probably Yubi Kiri, but it might just be because it's like new and stuff. But yeah, that question. What do you think, Frankie?
I honestly can't remember the tutorial that much, but yeah, I'd say Yubi Kiri.
Okay,
that was really good.
Are any of you going to the middle shows this summer?
No.
That's from
Toflock. I am.
Maybe. Wait,
okay. If you're going,
let's be nice.
Oh, actually backtracking a little. I forgot.
Australia sucks, so we get it.
All right. Okay, I'll shoot. Maybe I'll know when I say the joke. Okay. Yvonne, do you have anything to say about the Japanese thing?
What Japanese thing?
How about being proficient in Japanese and going to Japan? How well you need to be?
Yeah, TZ Queen asked, I'm studying Japanese, planning on taking N4 exam next year. Is that enough to talk there? Or is N3 enough? What do you feel about the levels of Japanese?
I actually don't know about the levels of Japanese. I feel like if you just know basic Japanese, that'll be more than enough to get you around, as long as you do research before you go. So before you go, you should really like check your train times, know exactly where you're going, at what day, and stick to that schedule. as well. Just make a schedule for yourself.
Or how about minimize
your speaking time.
But what if you wanted to speak?
If you do want to speak, I feel like just basic Japanese will get you around, and basic English will get you around. Because a lot of the station people, what I feel like a requirement for their job is that they should have at least a high level of English speaking so that, to accommodate to the foreigners.
In Tokyo.
In Tokyo.
Other places. In Tokyo. Other places.
If you're like in the countryside, you're screwed. All right?
Yeah, you're screwed. If you don't speak Japanese, you're screwed.
But if you're in Tokyo, you'll be fine with minimal Japanese.
Yeah, and getting around won't be a problem.
I wouldn't be leaving right now. I have to make a departure from the show. Okay. But I wish you guys the best of luck. Okay. I'll see you next time, friends. See you later.
See you later.
How are you?
But if you want to have in-depth conversations with some Japanese person, you're going to have to know quite a bit.
Yeah.
But yeah, just getting around, it won't be a problem. There's some people that go there, speak no Japanese at all, and they get around just fine. But yeah.
Oh. Another question is, Duels Marina asked, if you had the chance to meet a graduate, and what graduate would you meet and why? Good question. Maybe think Renown. Renown, because from everything I've seen in like videos and interviews and stuff with her, I've always been curious of what goes on in her head. So
you wanna get
I'd have maybe like a translator with me to what goes on inside the head of Renown. Yeah. So Reno, he went to do an emergency. So Austin, what's yours? Yes.
Mine is going to be Moa, because my favorite graduate overall. She seems like she has personality overall. She's like, you know, she's pretty easygoing, not really quiet. Not quiet, but not loud like Mirena. But yeah, she just seems like the kind of person I would want to meet. Really cool. Get to know her outside of Big Metal NSG. Yeah, and then what's the strangest thing you ate there? Squid. I've never had squid, so it's kind of weird.
You're from Texas. Seafood is not too apparent over there, so sorry about that. Seafood is great. For me, I'm gonna answer this question because I went last year, but not this year, unfortunately. I went not RGG, but Japan. There's this thing called, I wouldn't really call it weird, but this thing called kushiyage. It's where you take foods from like a island all-you-can-eat place, and then like you deep fry it. So it's like Korean barbecue, if anybody's had Korean barbecue, or like hot pot. But instead of like frying it or whatever, you deep fry it. So there'd be like fruits, meats, some seafoods. You just put it in and you just deep fry it. You bread it up and then you deep fry it. I wouldn't really call it weird, but something different that I haven't seen before. So
we have a question from a very long name that to say it.
Which one?
They said, honestly, are there enough foreign fans to make even the slightest impact on any of Amuse's decisions regarding SG? I don't think so. I think the only put English subs on something. That's like probably the biggest, the most it would go.
Yeah.
The furthest it would go. And
definitely. I agree.
Maybe if we get big enough. I don't know. Doug Moore asks, wait, got time for maybe two more questions. Doug Moore asks, do you think SG Style Group would be marketed in a Western setting? How would they need to change to make it work? I don't know. I don't think it could, because
I don't think so.
Like the age is such an important factor in like a lot of
Western countries.
Yeah, a lot of Western countries. So like a lot of people would be like turned like it's the cultural thing that like Japan, it just seems like they're just seen as like idols, and like they don't really look too much into the ages or anything. Well, over here where age is a big factor when you do anything, so
yeah,
I don't think it might work. And I honestly don't know how they would market it to Western setting if they had to.
When will Baby Metal... Doug also asked, when will Baby Metal play Australia? The answer to that is never.
No comment? Question.
Seen the Sakura in Japan. That's from Jules Marina. Yes, I saw a fair bit when I was there.
I saw it last year. Shotep asks, what do you think Hana's interacting more with fans this year, Torahime? Is she still training there? I'm not sure if she's still training there, but I think she's doing that because of SG and more Fukei going to Japan.
Here's the actual reason.
But here's insider scoop from Fukei Metal.
Insider reason. It's not too insider, but for the spring break, she on the floor, or like not working out, but like she started working on the floor, and like she started seating people and bringing people food instead of being in the kitchen where she normally is.
Mm-hmm.
She's actually able to come to the tables where the Fukei are and like seat them and give them, you know, drinks and whatnot. So it gives that opportunity to talk to her more. So I think Japanese fans that are like more regular there, we're like really happy that she was able to come out and actually talk to them, because that's like a never thing. That never happens. Oh wait, did I mention? I don't think I mentioned this. I completely forgot. Hana, take our picture.
Oh, like snaps! We need to hear that story.
So we're gonna ask her to take a picture. Because we wanted a picture taken at the venue, or at Torahime. And so one of our Japanese friends asked Hana if she could, like a little group picture. And she said, yeah. And so we went over to the wall and she took a picture. She took it three times because we a picture on each person's phone. So there's three pictures, and actually, if you look closely in the reflection of the picture, you can see her in the reflection, but we don't have that picture to show on the podcast for reasons.
Business reasons.
Privacy reasons.
Business reasons.
Yeah, business reasons.
Koba's not related to this, but blame, business hashtag blame Koba. He's not related to this at all, but blame Koba.
Yeah. And if you don't already know, Hana's not allowed to be in photos.
Yeah.
Or take.
Yeah.
You're not allowed to take any photos of the cast.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah. All right. Concludes our Q&A segment. Thank you everyone for your questions.
Dang.
Next thing, one big shout out to all the birthdays this month. Rao, Uga, Megu, Marina, Hayami, all have birthdays this month. Happy birthday to all of them. Quite a lot of birthdays for the month. Yeah, happy birthday to those members, graduates.
Oh yeah, dude. Okay, I have something to say about this.
All right, what'd you guys say? Say it loud and proud.
I'm really sad we didn't get a picture of Olga, and I was hoping for one. And that's...
Yeah.
Really sad we didn't get one. And I feel like somebody would have posted something, like Erica girl posting a picture of Olga like on her Instagram or something, but nothing. We get so few pictures of her.
So that was more than Nene. More than Nene. Speaking of Nene, small, to harp on the back of the RTG thing, but NHMR reunited for RTG, assuming so. And I got a picture of them again. It's nice to see. Nene's pretty as always. Yay.
Nene. So a rare person to see now these days.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. All right. And moving on to our game section. All right. All right.
Photo taken by Hana. Yes. Yes, yeah. That answer to that question is yes, TZ-kun. Photo taken by Hana.
Mm-hmm.
If, you know, if you count the reflection.
In the reflection, yeah. Yeah. But moving on. We're going to have our game segment this time. Game's called Countdown. And pretty much just of it is you have to make up whoever makes up the longest word from a set of letters wins. And the way it works is...
Oh, good.
Or you can explain.
I was going to say the set of letters that we draw or that we get is going to be picked by one of us. We're going to take turns drawing letters. So the first round, it'll be, let's say it'll be me. And the second round, it'll be Sour Patch Man. Second round. And for one round, you draw 9 letters. Each time you'll say if you want a vowel or a consonant. And when you say, let's say vowel, you'll get a random vowel. When you say consonant, you'll get a random consonant. And you do that until you get 9. So I draw the first 9. And then all 3 of us will try to make the longest word possible from those 9. We'll write it down. And at the end of the 30 seconds, which is what you get to make a word, you'll reveal your longest word and see who wins that round.
Yay. Each person takes turns picking all the letters for that round, by the way. So one person will pick all letters for the round. So it's not like one person each, like, decides on the letter. It's vowels and consonants, and then whoever, one person decides the vowels and consonants. Well, not like on them, but they decide if they need vowels or consonants. Get it? Well, if you don't, well, you'll get it as we move along.
But so, no, you'll get the hang of it.
You'll get it after you see. All right. Who wants to go first? Let's go chat. Who do you want to decide on the letters first? Pick one.
It's going to take a while for them to answer.
Wait a minute. Enjoy this nice spring.
Yes, let's take a
Saturday.
A moment of silence.
We'll take the first name out of 3 of us.
Yeah, take the first name. 3 of us. Bukumano, Sarfaz, Parent, or Suti? Or Austin, Frankie, Gabe?
Conjoined.
Yeah.
It is Suti, by the way.
No one cares. I'm just kidding. But I'm not. But I am.
Suti, okay.
Suti, you're first up to bat.
All right, so once I get the approval text, I'll start calling out vowels or consonants.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right, let's go. Start up.
Huh?
I said start up.
Oh, I thought you said stop. Okay, consonants. Start up.
Yes, we are limited to English.
This is English.
Sorry.
So the first letter is N. Let's go with a vowel. A. Consonant. C. Vowel. I. Consonant. S. Another vowel. U. Vowel. The next vowel was E, so consonant. It's an L. So for the last one, I think I will choose another consonant. So last consonant is P. So now we'll take 30 seconds from the word. Once we get the okay from our tech team, we'll take 30 seconds to try to come up with the longest word possible. Oh, well, okay, maybe not from our tech team. Maybe I'll time this.
Okay.
It's your real time this.
From our tech team, then. We'll start from our tech team. He can give us the go for the 30 seconds, and we'll start from there.
All right. Ready?
No, again, Chuck.
Yeah, got it.
Okay, I have my word. Wait, oh, we're supposed to say it out loud now?
No, we do that at the end of the time.
Damn it.
Okay. I guess I'll go first since I did the drawing. I have planes. PLANES. Planes.
I almost had that. You had a bigger.
Anybody have a bigger word, or just want
to? I have one. My word, capsule.
Capsule.
Did I spell that right?
Yeah, you got it.
Yeah.
All I got was Lance. So, think of anything more.
You could have done Lance's.
Awesome. Yeah. Plane without the S. Okay.
We also get points based on how long our word.
Yeah, so you get points based on and bonus points for SG related stuff. So
Gabe got Lance, so that's 5 points. I got planes, which is 6 points. And Austin, what was your word again, Austin?
Capsule?
Oh, capsule, which is 7 points. So right now, Austin is in the lead.
Wait, we're doing this by like.
Yeah, that's my point. It's determined by the.
We don't get one whole point for that nope. Longest person being their own.
From what I understood, it's a point system. 7, 6, 5.
Is it? Tech team, can you confirm this?
The longest
and Patsy, I don't think you can repeat the letters.
He said no, but we'll go with it. Okay, whatever. Oh.
And Pelicans was good. I
didn't think about it too.
Pelicans, that's good. Good work. Good job. Drive on middle.
All right.
And Patsy.
All right, who's next?
I guess Austin got the most. Go with Austin.
Rip.
Give me a vowel. Okay.
First letter is U.
Consonant.
Next letter is G.
And another vowel.
Next letter is E.
I think he said vowel.
Letter is I.
A consonant.
So letter is D.
Another consonant. And another consonant. A vowel. So
letter is Y. Letters I again. 7.
Wait, two more. I said consonant, right? Consonant.
Oh, well, consonant then.
Z. Oof. Z.
And got another consonant.
Okay. What the hell?
J. Ah.
This is gonna be hard.
Yeah.
Okay, so once our tech team gives us the go, we'll have 30 seconds to make the longest word possible that we can think of from these interesting letters. And the 30 seconds starts now.
Alrighty.
Stop. Okay, time's up.
Time's up.
Who wants to start?
I'll go first since I chose the crap. So I did really bad. All I came up with
was
big D-I-G.
D-I-G, okay.
All right, I'm next. I got judge.
Judge.
Boom. How do you guys not see that?
All I got was die.
Really? Yeah. I suck at Scrabble, so.
Somebody says Jedi.
There's also IDZ.
Guide.
IDZ in there too. IDZ.
Oh yeah.
Somebody said guide. Somebody said
bonus points, right?
See, Kyle also guessed judge. So, I don't think that's a bonus.
So, in terms of points, Austin should have 10. I should have 9, and Gabe should have 10 as well, I think.
Is that
so
right?
It's tied between first place, between Austin and Gabe for 10 points, and me following in second with 9 points. So, still a really close game.
What language is that? All right.
So now we can move on to third round, where Gabe will...
My turn? All right. Tech team ready. Waiting to reset. All right. You guys ready for this?
Yep.
Vowel.
And the first vowel coming up in a few seconds is O.
Vowel.
Next vowel is I.
Vowel.
Next vowel. Is a U.
Vowel.
Next vowel is a I.
Another vowel.
The fifth vowel in a row is an A.
Consonant.
The first consonant is a H.
Consonant again.
The next consonant is a N.
And again.
The next consonant is a V.
And then, eight? Yep. One more. Vowel again.
And the last letter and vowel is a...
E?
No, there is a miss. The last vowel...
No, yeah, it's not C, it's a vowel. It will be vowel.
Oh, well, we're going to go with C.
All right, we'll stick with C, it's fine.
Okay, once our tech team gives, we'll have 30 seconds to come up with the best word possible.
Oh, we're stuck.
Ready, and go. Okay, time's up.
All right.
Gabe, through this, he'll start.
Cuban,
5 points. I also only got a five-letter cabin. So right now the points are 15 and 14, and we'll see if Austin can come up with a six-letter word to beat Gabe or a five-letter word to tie.
I could not. I am only at ban, B-A-N.
Banned for 4 points. So that equals 14. Me and Austin tied for second place. And the winner, surprisingly,
Gabe.
Come 15 back. Points.
So it's solid English, though. Like, SC really crap.
Yeah.
Oh, you could have made, like, Bo or something, but... Or, oh.
I mean...
Oh, you know, I should have went for Chow, yeah. But I should have went for Chow.
Yeah, Chow.
I thought about that, but I wasn't sure, like, if... That was
it's in two specific. Languages. It's in two categories. It's a thing, but it's not a thing.
Yeah, I mean, English sprawls stuff all the time. English is pretty English.
Ionic.
Oh, man.
So, what's the score? The
you 15, me and Austin 14, or Austin and I.
Oof.
So close game.
Close. Very close.
No re though.
Yeah, no re. You guys blew the lead. Were you the Warriors?
Well, no, we're the Atlanta.
Oh, too soon.
Right. Somebody said sports. I didn't think of that.
Sports. All right. And this looks like we're just about it on our time. So thank you, everybody, for joining us.
Thank you. That was.
I think we got a record number of viewers this time. So, yay. You guys are awesome.
I can't we'll see be doing it, but I'll find out later.
I think we got like 28 or something. But
that's good. Joined for this RTG podcast. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry for everybody who cried unexpectedly. We should have given a proper fuels warning, but.
Crying is good for you. It's good for the soul. Good. Good.
It's always good, right, food, but not good for the art.
Yeah. Yep.
All right. Thanks, guys, for joining our show. Be sure to catch the next one, which will be after the transfer ceremony. So we'll know by then who new transfer in, and we'll have a whole show talking about them and what we expect and other things related to the topic.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
So look out for the date.
Thank you. For all your questions, questionnaire section.
And your support. Thank you, everybody.
You loyal viewers.
Bye.
Tune in. Bye. If Upgun here, you'd say, Kirits.
No.
Yotsuke. Thanks.
All right. I'm not standing.
I'm not standing. Because...
for calling you.
Bye.
Bye.
Kano 2019.
All right, we're extending this ending a little bit too long. But we're gonna go.
Yo, what? We got credits now? What the hell?
We have credits.
Oh, yo, tech team stepping it up. What the heck? All right, I'm done.
Okay,
I'm going over my own. All right, bye now. Bye.
Thanks. Shout out to guy Doug.
Shout out to Doug, the man, the myth, the legend, putting all this work. Bye.
See you.